In the Rotary year 2013-2014, the Rotary Club of Buckhead did so many things to benefit our business community, the community of Atlanta, and our relationships with people around the world that it would be hard to show it all in one place. But here's a sampling of what our club did. The Rotary International theme this last year was Engage Rotary, Change Lives. We did engage Rotary, and it did change lives. We inducted 18 new members to spread our influence and serve the world community. And that makes us 172 members strong. Our 172 members were active. They filled 124 committee slots, and our members went to work in 11 avenues of Rotary service. They accomplished 25 service projects, both here and abroad. Our club president, Bill Knight, brought to bear almost 20 years of service at Buckhead Rotary. He had served as president of the Georgia Tech Alumni Association, and his hair has been blown by the vicissitudes of Atlanta commercial real estate. A gracious host to our speakers, he oversaw the work of all our committees.
There's a board meeting at Brio's tonight, 5:30, and the trustees of the Buckhead Rotary Foundation will meet in that room right after our meeting today.
But beware of the caveman he turns into at night.
We are working diligently in conjunction with the Ronald McDonald Charity, and we're going to be giving them $100,000.
Elizabeth Gill was our club's president-elect.
I'm Elizabeth Gill, past president of the Buckhead Business Association. I'm here with one of our bucks on the street.
And our secretary, Ty Tippett, kept track of everything. A lawyer and auctioneer extraordinaire, he raised money for our projects.
It's not just doing good. It's good for Atlanta business.
The man with the Rotary halo was our treasurer, who it is rumored still holds the record for most passes caught in a Florida State football game. Of course, some of those passes, it is rumored, were caught during halftime. And our immediate past president was Candace Klein, whose tough experience as a contractor belies the fact that she started our program Companions for Heroes. Our members accomplished an amazing amount, and it was done with a lot of careful planning, like the leadership that was provided for our inaugural golf tournament, and the boots-on-the-ground administration that made it a major success, both as an event and for the charities that it benefited. And we continue to honor great leaders outside of our club for their work that enriches the lives of us all, like the Robert Ross Johnson Humanitarian Award that has been granted by this club each year for 15 years. So let's take a look at some of the recognition our club received for our work, both in Atlanta and abroad. Some of that came in the form of awards from our Rotary District 6900. Best website for the second year in a row. Designed by past President Alec, it has led to his commission to design the website for our entire district. You can find everything you need or want to know about our club, our programs, and members of each committee, including information about each Buckhead Rotarian. Best Museum Display. Now this just proves the truth of the saying, the only difference between grown men and boys is the price of their toys. And this thing was amazing. Designed to display at the district conference our club's accomplishments, it also presented each element of the district conference theme. Each piece was designed to go together just right, and it did. Would you dare not follow the plan of this man? So even the chairman of the committee pitched in and led even new members to conference success. And another of our technical wizards and a past president continued to oversee the conference audiovisual and production staff. Laws of Life. Here's a little bit about this terrific statewide program that is run by Susan Mason. It's an essay contest that encourages high school students to write about their lives in a way that helps them move toward the next step. The student you're about to meet went from living in a car on the street to now working on her Doctor of Medicine degree.
The Rotary Club opened up doors in my life of opportunity. I didn't even know the doors were there.
Today, the Laws of Life contest is not just the largest high school contest in the United States, it's the largest essay contest of any kind in North America.
Our club works closely with Boy Scouts of America and also supplies over 600 Eagle Scout badges. We continued our years-long work with the students of KIPP schools, where 80% of the graduates go on to college all across the United States. We visit them at their school to let them know that we're their friends, and they visit our club several times each year. We worked closely, as we have for years, with Atlanta's great international school with over 1,000 students, and our member, the headmaster, made high standards of education seem like fun. We honored great students with the Otis Jackson Scholarship, a program of grants unique to this club, and our club continued its participation in the Georgia Rotary Student Program, which provides an exchange of international ideas, this year with Wafa Benelou from France. Our families grew close during the year, and we added to our understanding of each other. The annual 7th grade basketball tournament is a major event in Buckhead Rotary Youth Service.
It started in 1965 when Buckhead Rotarian, Garland Penholster, suggested we start a league for the 7th grade teams in the northwest side of Atlanta.
The quality of this 7th grade basketball has to be seen to be believed, and seems to improve each year. The quality of play in our high school tennis tournament seems almost professional. This year, unfortunately, it got rained out, but normally it draws high school teams from all over the region for a full weekend of top-notch competition. With so many teams, it has to be held in 3 locations. The Al Daniel Membership Award is unique to this club. We can't win it. That's because we award it. It is named in honor of past President Al Daniel, shown here with Mayor Ivan Allen at the induction of Robert Woodruff into our club. Buckhead Rotary is the only service club Mr. Woodruff ever joined, and on the condition that we would never let it be known when he granted one of our requests. Al Daniel went on to induct more new members into this club than anyone before or since, and our club continued this year in the tradition that new members are the lifeblood of Rotary. International service continued as one of the most important functions of Rotary International and of Buckhead Rotary. Polio, once thought to be in check, has once again begun to spread due in large part to migrations as a result of growing conflicts around the world. And we prepared to increase our efforts, along with Rotary International and foundations like the Gates Foundation, to eradicate this disease. We responded to Governor Blake's call for aid to support typhoon relief in the Philippines. We contributed to the efforts to curb the severity of AIDS in Africa, one of the most effective programs in recent years. And past President Candace reported to the district on our new 3-year sister club relationship with the Rotary Club of Curacao, on our recent visit to their club, and our joint aid through global grants to improve literacy and the effectiveness of their teachers. One of the most fun service projects here in Atlanta is Apples for Teachers, where we polish more than 3,000 apples to show our appreciation for the work our teachers do.
My name is Kelly Green with the Buckhead Rotary Club. I'm the chairperson of the Apples for Teachers Committee, where each year we hand polish about 3,200 apples and hand deliver them the following day to teachers throughout the Atlanta area. And thanks for what they do for us each day. We thank you so much, Ms. Hall. This apple's for you. Thank you.
Even Whitney's new baby geared up for the work. But most important about those 3,000 apples is that each one was delivered with a copy of the Rotary 4-Way Test. We supported the semi-annual Georgia Mission of Mercy, where people come from all over the region for free dental care, and sometimes even extensive work, all donated by our area dentists. And our Caring Hands Committee continued its care and support for our members and their families and kept our club informed as to a member's needs. And it broadened its work to send packages of appreciation to our overseas troops. Our very own Robert Ross Johnson Award is given each year in the name of our club's past chaplain with the purpose to honor an Atlanta leader outside of Buckhead Rotary. This year's award given to Dr. William Fagey for his groundbreaking research on the methods and effectiveness of fighting epidemics and infectious disease.
First of all, thank you so much for this tremendous honor, and it is so nice to meet you, Mr. Johnson, and Sydney, to meet you. I grew up 60 miles from where your husband grew up. He was in Spokane, I was 60 miles north of Spokane. It's clear that he was such a special person, but it's clear that this is a special club that wants to keep remembering special people.
Just as we have worked for 15 years to honor such greats as Dan Cathy, Bernie Marcus, and the Shepherd family, in the same way our charity ball honored Laura and Rutherford Seidel for their work on the environment, work that complements our club's work on the Buckhead environment and the nature preserves that enrich our lives. And the ball raised money from contributions over and above what our members give as a matter of course, and also from donations from people and companies outside our club, all of which is added to by the sale of items donated for auction at the ball. And all this was added to our foundation corpus of over $1,250,000. The foundation corpus was supplemented even more this year by our inaugural and very successful golf tournament, where we partnered with 31 corporations and the Ronald McDonald Charities to raise money not only for our foundation, but also for a $100,000 gift to the McDonald House Charities. Now, if you're wondering how your individual contributions fit into all this, they actually make up about 50% of all charitable spending of this club. But if you want to know the math behind how all that is added up, well, this is about the best explanation we've got.
Lee Duns will give us a brief presentation about some changes in our invoicing format that might be a little bit confusing.
Thank you, Bill. I want to clear up a little confusion about charitable contributions. A little history. In the old days, we used to overcharge everybody for dues and meals. And we took the profit and we used that to fund our philanthropic activities. And part of the profit was that nobody, you know, a lot of people don't eat all the meals that you pay for, so that created some profit. So what we did is we reduced the cost of the meals and the dues. And we took the difference in the quarterly bills and we called that a charitable contribution. So we didn't reduce anybody's quarterly bills.
Now, if that didn't clear that up, just take solace in the knowledge we gained from great programs we had, from politicians to captains of industry, to the men who enforce our laws, and our weekly edition of great and often noble friends, and be glad for the great Rotary year 2013-2014. And look now for clues about next year in the report on the Rotary International Convention just held in Australia.
Today. It was the 105th Rotary Convention, and there were 18,000 people there from 154 countries. The president of Rotary International, his name is Gary Hong, and he is from Taiwan. And he makes you sing and clap and all, you know, in Taiwanese. Really fun.
And like all Buckhead Rotary years, the year 2013-2014 laid a stronger foundation for the next year to come.
Thank you, Bill, for your leadership in 2013-14. You are a great president for this club.